This is Leica's new AP20 AutoPole, an inertial measurement unit, or an IMU, for data collection with a surveying total station. Now the AP20 provides a lot of great benefits to anyone that is doing surveying with their total station. Some of these benefits include a tilt compensator, AutoPole height calculations, and target ID, which allows it to find this prism and not lock onto any foreign objects. Now attaching the AP20 is really quite simple. You would simply remove the prism from your pole, take the AP20, slide it onto Leica's AutoPole, make sure it's locked into place, put the prism back on, and there we go. Everything is now set up and ready to be used. Now with traditional rods, in order to capture a proper reading, you need to make sure that the bubble is in the center and the rod is plumb. This also means if the rod is slightly to the left or to the right, then the total station is going to measure that position even though it's not plumb, and it won't provide us with the correct position of the point that we're trying to observe. However, that's not the case when you use the AP20. Now I can hold the pole in any orientation or any direction because the built-in IMU will use a tilt compensator to calculate the position of the prism and provide my total station with accurate positions as though I was holding my rod plumb. Another benefit of the AP20 is the efficiency in which we collect data. Making sure you stop at every single point and ensuring that your rod is plumb will take several minutes, whereas if I'm able to just take an observation on the fly, knowing that my compensator is working, I'll be able to do a topographic survey, for example, much quicker because I know that my positions are being calculated correctly and I don't have to worry about plumbing the rod at every single shot. Having the ability to take a measurement on a slanted angle like this means that we can now observe positions of points that we couldn't have with a traditional rod. This can include building corners rather than taking a reflectorless shot or holding it close to the building and doing an offset. It could also mean manholes that are underneath cars that we need rim elevations for, or anything with a base that would be very difficult to grab by holding the rod plumb. So now that you understand what the AP20 is and how it works, let me show you how to initialize it. Now to start, you're going to go ahead and just power on the AP20. Okay, very good. And now in our controller, let's set up the wizard to connect to the AP20. So now in Leica Captivate, I've created a job, I've called it AP20, and I'm going to select settings. I'll come over here to connections, and I'm going to select the AP connection wizard. This will ask me now for the sensor. I want the AP20, and the sensor that's going to connect to is the total station's long range handle. I'll go ahead and hit next, and then I'll hit next. And now it's going to search for the AP20. There it is, AP20. And there we go, now it is connected to the AP20. The only other thing it's gonna ask me for is the point at which the total station is set up on. I'm set up on point number one, so I'll just hit finish. All right, now the connection light has gone from green to blue, which means we are now connected to a total station. And we see this red little prism right here. And that just tells us that our AP20 is not initialized and that we need to generate some movement in order for the IMU to begin compensating for its position. Now what I'll start by doing is raising the rod so it's over my head. And that little beep means that the AutoPole has generated a pole height and I don't need to insert my pole height anymore. No, really, look, here I have the pole set to 5.2 feet. All I'm gonna do is raise it to, let's say, 6 feet. Now the target height has updated and now it says that it's 6 feet. If I wanted to get a pole height that was really, really high, let's do, I don't know, 6.8. There we are, now we have 6.8. And so this eliminates the error of having an incorrect pole height input into the controller in comparison to the actual pole height. And that's thanks to our AP20. All right, now I'm gonna have the total station search and find my prism.
Lock to target.
All right, and it's locked to target. And while I have the total station locked to the prism, I'm now going to click on start tilt. So now the total station is measuring the position of my prism and it's got this beeping noise that shows that it's taking distances. Now in order to initialize the compensation for the AP20, I'm going to need to move in a linear path, move my rod around, kind of like I'm doing figure eights with a drone, in order to initialize the IMU inside of the AP20.
Tilt compensation started.
All right, now the tilt compensation has started and our AP20 is initialized. And as you can see here, the compensator is now green and it is initialized. Now the first thing I wanna test out is the speed at which I can survey the sidewalk. I'm gonna do this traditionally without the AP20 and see how long it takes me. And then I'll attach the AP20 back onto our pole to see how much faster we can survey the sidewalk.
Lock to target.
All right, we're gonna go ahead and start measuring points. I've got my phone out and start.
Point stored.
And roughly 10 seconds to survey this little bit of sidewalk without the AP20. All right, let's go ahead and attach the AP20.
Connected to AutoPole.
All right, we're connected to the AutoPole. I'll go ahead and raise this up to 6 feet. It's already updated the height.
Lock to target.
Okay, perfect. And I'm gonna pick up the rod and start the compensator, and hopefully it will connect and initialize the IMU.
Tail compensation started.
Well, that was fast. And let's start.
Point stored.
Stop the clock. And there it is, 1:04. It took us half as much time to do this with the AP20 than conventionally with our rod. Now, I know what a lot of you are thinking. This might be a cool little IMU that I can attach onto my survey rod and speed up my efficiency and eliminate the potential rod height error. But how accurate is it? Well, today I've put 3 orange stakes into the ground. Now, all 3 of these stakes were set on a little hill here to ensure that I have different elevations on all of them. And what I'm gonna start by doing is removing the AutoPole and measuring all of these stakes traditionally to get the coordinates of them. That's what's really gonna test this AP20's IMU and how well the tilt compensator can calculate the true coordinates of our points. I'm actually going to use this bipod just to really ensure that the bubble here is in the center and that our rod is plumb. Okay, looks good. All right, now I'm gonna go ahead and make the total station search for me. There we go.
Lock to target.
All right, we're plumb on this point. I'm at 6 feet. Everything looks good, and I'll hit store.
Point stored.
All right, let's go ahead and take our pole and head over to the next point. Here we go. All right, everything looks good, and we'll store this point.
Point stored.
Okay, great. And now we'll pick up our pole and go to the last point right over here. And we will store.
Point stored.
Okay, great. We've got all 3 of those points stored. Now let's get rid of the bipods and add our AP20. Okay, here we go.
Tilt compensation started.
We've started the tilt compensator. I'm gonna come over to my first point. I'm gonna go ahead and just, I don't know, lean this like that, and I'm gonna store.
Point stored.
I'll come over to our next point. Here on my second point, I don't know, I'll lean it like this. This looks good.
Point stored.
All right, the last point. I just want to show you guys how there is the graphic here on Leica Captivate. It can see, graphically speaking, where the pole is. I'm gonna get really tilted here on this one. I shall tilt to the right and to the back. There it is, and we'll hit store.
Point stored.
All right. Let's take a look at those differences. All right, so let's take a look at the points that we measured. So the diamond number is the average between the first and second shot. So let's ignore those numbers for now. The first number that you see is the shot that we took with the prism alone. The second shot is with the AP20 tilt correction. And for point number 201, it looks like in the northing, we are exactly right on. In the easting, we have a difference of about 2/100ths of a foot. And in the elevation, we have a difference of about 1/100th of a foot. Wow, that's incredible. For point 202, we have a difference of 5/1000ths in the northing, about 1/100th in the easting, and about 6/1000ths in the elevation. Wow, 202, I have to say, is pretty much right there. And finally, point 203, looks like we got about 1/100th of error in the northing, about 1/100th in the easting, and we're 2/100ths in the elevation. With about 1 to 2/100ths of a foot in error, I can confidently say that the AP20 is a great tool for any surveyor to use. I hope you guys liked today's video. If you did, make sure you subscribe to the YouTube channel for more great surveying content.